point.
These are Alliance soldiers. It appears they were lured here by the distress beacon.
Looks like these men were under Admiral Kahoku's command. You'd want to know what happened here.
I never properly thanked you for saving me from the Geth, Commander. If you hadn't shown up, I...
I'm just glad we got there in time.
So am I. I know you took a chance bringing me aboard this ship. I have seen the way your crew looks at me. They do not trust me. But I am not like Benezia. I will do whatever I can to help you stop Saren. I promise.
Don't worry, Liara. I trust you. I know you won't let me down.
It means a lot to hear you say that, Commander. Thank you.
Do you know why Benezia joined up with Saren?
I don't understand it. She was always outspoken about the need for the Asari to become more involved in shaping galactic events. Maybe she thought allying herself with Saren would somehow be for the greater good in the long run. At least I hope so.
This hurts you, doesn't it?
None of this makes any sense to me. I have not spoken to Benezia in many years, but I know her, and this was not like her. Something changed.
I'd like to know more about the Asari.
We were the first species to discover the Citadel. We were instrumental in forming the Council, and we always strive to be the voice of peaceful cooperation in galactic disputes. My people believe we are all part of a single galactic community. Each species contributes something to the greater whole. Although we seek to understand other species, it seems few of them seek to understand us. The galaxy is filled with rumors and misinformation about my people.
Like what?
Most of the inaccuracies are centered around our mating rituals. My species is monogendered. Male and female have no real meaning for us. We still require a partner to reproduce. This second parent, however, may be of any species and any gender.
I don't understand. Your species can mate with anyone?
Mating is not quite the proper term, not as you understand it. Physical contact may or may not be involved, but it is not an essential element of the union. The true connection is mental. Our physiology allows us to meld with other beings. We can touch the very depths of their minds. We explore the genetic memory of their species. We share the most basic elements of their individual and racial identities. We then pass these traits on to our daughters. It is how we learn to grow as a species and how we develop a greater understanding of other races.
What happens to your partner after the union?
Every relationship is different. Some unions are a single encounter with both parents parting ways afterwards. Others can be more long-term. Sometimes an Asari and her partner will stay together for many decades.
Do you know who Matriarch Benezia chose as her partner?
She rarely spoke of her partner. Though I know my father, if you want to use that term, was another Asari.
I thought you always needed another species to serve as one of the parents.
Think about it, Shepard. If we were not able to mate with our own species, we would have died out long before we ever mastered spaceflight and left our homeworld. Union with our own kind is no longer common, not for the purposes of reproduction. Most Asari believe it weakens our species. Asari daughters inherit racial traits from the father species. If both parents are Asari, then nothing has been gained, or so conventional wisdom would hold. I am what is sometimes called a pureblood, though no Asari would ever be cruel enough to say the word to my face. It is a great insult among my people. It is possible Benezia's partner was embarrassed by their union. She may have been too ashamed to publicly acknowledge me as her offspring.
How could anyone abandon their own child?
I cannot answer that. This is all speculation on my part. It is possible she wanted to be part of my life, but something happened to her before she had the chance. Benezia never spoke of her partner. Whatever happened, it caused her too much pain to dwell on it. She raised me by herself, though that is not uncommon. Many Asari raise their children alone, particularly if the father species is short-lived. Often the partner will pass on long before the child reaches maturity.
You Asari live for 1,000 years. What happens when your partner dies?
Few sapient species live as long as my kind. We have learned to take a philosophical approach to our unions. We do not focus on the inevitable loss of our partners. Instead, we enjoy the time we spend with them. And even after they're gone, a part of them lives on in us. The union is a connection that transcends both time and space.
Do you know who Matriarch Benezia chose as her partner?
She rarely spoke of her.
Benezian.
It is possible Benezia's partner was embarrassed.
How could any...
Many Asari raise their children alone, particularly if the father... Goodbye, Commander. I get the feeling you want to ask me something, Commander.
Tell me about yourself, Liara.
Me? I am afraid I am not very interesting, Commander. I spend most of my time on remote digs, unearthing mundane items buried in long-forgotten Prothean ruins.
Sounds dangerous. And lonely.
Sometimes I would run afoul of indigenous life forms or stumble across a small band of mercenaries or privateers, but I was always careful. Until the Geth followed me to Artemis Tau, I never found myself in any situation my biotics could not handle. As for the solitude, well, that is one aspect that most appealed to me. Sometimes I just need to get away from other people.
You don't like other people?
I suppose it comes from being a matriarch's daughter. People expected me to follow in Benezia's footsteps. They wanted me to become a leader of our people. Matriarchs guide their followers into the future. They seek the truth of what is yet to come. Maybe that's why I became so interested in the secrets of the past. It sounds so foolish when I say it out loud. It sounds like I became an archaeologist simply to spite Benezia.
All children rebel against their parents. It's a natural part of growing up.
Uh-huh. You share the wisdom of the matriarch, Shepard. That is exactly what Benezia said when I told her of my decision. But there was more to it than that. I felt drawn to the past. The Protheans were these wondrous, mysterious figures. I wanted to know everything about them. That is why I find you so fascinating. You were marked by the beacon on Eden Prime. You were touched by working Prothean technology.
Sounds like you want to dissect me in a lab somewhere.
What? No! I did not mean to insinuate. I never meant to offend you, Shepard. I only meant that you would be an interesting specimen for an in-depth study. No, that's even worse.
Calm down, Liara. I was only joking.
Joking? Oh, by the goddess, how could I be so dense? You must think I am a complete and utter fool. Now you know why I prefer to spend my time in the field with data disks and computers. I always seem to say something embarrassing around other people. Please, just pretend this conversation never happened.
I should go.
Goodbye, Shepard.
Yes, Commander? Is there something you need?
I should go.
Goodbye, Commander.
Thank you.
I'm on my way.
Spotted.
Regroup.
I'm on my way.
Huddle up. disabled.
Locked and loaded.
Enemy is everywhere! Enemy is everywhere!
Shields disabled. Good to go.
transmission. You hear me? They haven't found me yet, but I can't talk long. Shut down the fusion torches. I'm going to die. God, I hope you're hearing this.
Thank you. Check! Check!
Take him out!
I hear you. What's going on? Who are you?
My name's Kate Bowman. I'm an engineer. I was part of the team assigned to bring this asteroid to Terra Nova.
We were attacked yesterday by Batarian extremists. I've been hiding since they arrived. I think they know the torch went out.
Why are they doing this?
I don't know, but if this asteroid isn't slowed, millions of people on Terra Nova are going to die.
If I find out anything,
Good luck.
Oh, God. I didn't mean to... Are you hurt?
Takes more than one shot to bring me down.
Sorry. I didn't even realize you were human until... Well, guess I'm not much of a soldier.
I know you're scared, but I'm here to help. Commander Shepard with the Alliance.
Simon Atwell. I'm the chief engineer on this rock. Listen, we don't have much time. The Batarians fired up the fusion torches. You've got to shut them down before we hit Terra Nova. There are 4 million people down there, Shepard. My family. They live in Aronis. My kids and grandkids. Nice community. It's good schools.
I don't have time to do the math in my head. What happens if we don't stop this rock?
X-57 is 22 kilometers long, twice the size of the asteroid that wiped out the Earth's dinosaurs. It would be like millions of fusion bombs striking at once. Millions. The heat of the blast, 1,000 kilometers away, clothes will ignite. There'll be global wildfires. Air shock will flatten everything for hundreds of kilometers. Terra Nova will die, Shepard. Not just our colony, the planet. There'll be a climate shift, mass extinctions. The ecosystem won't recover for thousands of years. Millions, maybe.
Is there any chance it'll land in the oceans?
That would be even worse. Tsunamis would sweep inland at hundreds of kilometers per hour. Millions of tons of water would be vaporized at the point of impact. Global cloud coverage. The plants could all die, and if they go, the whole ecosystem rolls over. I'd have to run the numbers, but take my word for it, it'd be bad.
This doesn't make any sense. Batarians run criminal gangs. Unethical, but profitable. They don't destroy worlds. What does this gain them?
I've heard all the stories. Slave rings ranching people like animals. Pirate bands burning colonies to the ground. But this is... The Citadel Conventions forbid asteroid drops. I never thought the Batarians would go this far.
Most Batarians aren't genocidal madmen, but these are terrorists.
Yeah, I know. It's just... this isn't how I expected the world to be when I rolled out of bed this morning.
You were on the ground when this happened. How many Batarians have you seen? And where?
They landed at the main facility. It's locked down now. They've changed the passcodes. No idea what's going on inside. I did see groups head out to each of the torch stations. Couldn't say how many, though. Enough to give you a fight.
Any idea who's behind this? Who's leading them? That might provide a clue.
I heard a couple of them talking. They mentioned a Balak. It sounded like he's the one in charge. They didn't seem convinced this was a good idea, but they were scared of the guy. Scared enough to do what he wanted.
Batarians everywhere, and I need to shut down all three torches. Anything else I should know?
One of the torches is surrounded by live blasting caps. We were set up to excavate when we arrived at Terra Nova. I rigged them with proximity detectors. That tank of yours will set them off, so you'll have to go in on foot. Even then, they'll explode if you get too close. Just go slow and easy. You should be fine.
You set them up. Can you disable them?
Not from here. No. There are manual controls by the entrance to the torch facility inside the blast zone. You can disarm the caps there. One last thing. I had a crew working off-site when the attack hit. I'm worried about them. These Batarians are ruthless. I saw them smash the faceplates of guys working vacuum. And those Varan. I don't think they always wait for a corpse before feeding.
Any idea where I can find them?
They were running checks on our perimeter equipment. Easiest thing would be to tap into the transmission tower out on the surface. The equipment stations will show up on your sensors.
I'll look for them, but the torches have to be my priority.
Yeah, you're right. Saving Terra Nova is more important than my team. There were a bunch of engineers over at the main facility, but they're probably all dead. That or being held hostage by the Batarians.
A woman named Kate Bowman contacted me. The Batarians haven't found her yet.
Katie's alive? She's one of my best engineers. She signed on with her brother, Aaron, I think his name is. He's part of the security detail. I hope they're okay.
What can you tell me about Kate?
Smart as a whip and bold as they come. I hope she keeps hidden. If they find her... Oh, Katie, don't do anything stupid.
Why were you moving this thing in the first place?
Well, the idea was to drag it into Terra Nova's orbit, mine it out, and in the end you'd have a basic structure for an orbital station. It's a lot cheaper than getting everything up into orbit from the planet's surface. The minerals we extract almost cover the costs.
Give me a worst-case scenario. We can't stop the asteroid. Could the colony be evacuated?
Shepard, it took 30 years for the population to grow that large. I'm sure they're moving people to remote areas, but they'd never be able to get more than a few thousand off-world. We just don't have enough ships. No one does. Well, maybe the Quarians, but I don't see them suddenly showing up and offering us a ride.
You better find a good place to hide. If the Batarians come back and find you...
Yeah. I think I'll make myself scarce. Good luck, Shepard. Thank you.